So you've met the enemy, drawn up your battle plans.
Aye, for what there was.
You've known him for the space of a single conversation. You and your trusted advisors, and you sit around making your plans on how to defeat a man you don't know. I lived with him. I know the way his mind works. I know how he likes to hurt people. Did it ever once occur to you that I might have some insight?
You're right.
From the beginning, we knew that one thing we'd never had on the show was a true medieval pitched battle, where two sides bring all the forces they can into play in some battlefield that's somehow negotiated or agreed upon, and they go at each other until one of them wins and the other one loses. And we started to look through film examples of it. There really wasn't one that both made you feel what it was like to be there on the ground and gave you a sense of the geography of the battle.
Jon Snow is a very skilled combatant, but part of the reason he survives this battle is just he gets lucky.
We went back to the Roman fight against the Carthaginians in the Battle of Cannae, where the Romans got caught in an encirclement by Hannibal and just slaughtered. And we used that as sort of our model.
The Battle of the Bastards becomes incredibly compact. You read accounts of battles in the Civil War where the bodies were piled so thick it actually became an obstruction on the battlefield. Even for someone we love as much as John, just something so dehumanizing about it. And even his look, you know, he's so covered in blood and soot. There's like a wildness to him, especially after what he's seen. There's just no part of John that's not going to pursue.
The initial version of the battle all took place on the battlefield, but it was the battle for Winterfell. As we talked it through, it started to occur to us that the episode is really about bringing things home for John, having to fight for his home in his home. There's nothing he wants more than to beat Ramsay to death with his own fists. And then he sees his sister who suffered at the hands of this man, and he realizes that this person is not his to finish.
Hello, Sansa.
The show doesn't always give people the things that are gonna make them happy, but this felt like a moment where it made narrative sense that they would win this fight and that Ramsay would come into their possession as a prisoner. His dogs were such a thing for him in this season and in seasons past, and such an extension of his own horrible urges, and the idea that they would be turned against him and that it would happen at Sansa's hands made a lot of sense to us.
My hounds will never harm me.
You haven't fed them in 7 days. You said it yourself.
Stop! Stop! Stop!
This isn't the little girl who wanted to dress up like a princess anymore. Her walk away at the end of the scene, and that's one of my favorite shots we've ever had. Just the little ghost of a smile on her face. She's in Winterfell, but she's not the person she was when she first left.